movie for anyone who is into anything Korean will make its way to the big screen this April 8. Yung Libro sa Napanood Ko is one of the entries in the first summer edition of the Metro Manila Film Festival, which will kick off this Sunday. Here's a sneak peek.
So who do you want me to dedicate the book to?
To Mary.
That's a really nice name. Girlfriend?
No.
Kaya matamaan na lang ngayon sa talagang harap-harapan din na yung jowa nila.
She's not my jowa.
You know, jowa.
Why are limited?
Because I'm gonna eat. Nagugutom ako.
Sama ko? Why don't you go to Korea? Come with me.
No.
Come on.
No. Eh kasi naman, no. Load ka na load ng K-drama. Ayan na nga, di ka na nga pinapahirapan ni God, eh. Binigay na nga sa'yo.
If I could choose to live my life, there'll be no ifs to say. If I would choose to hold your hand, there'll be no words to say.
Choose to hold your hand. There will be no words to say.
It breaks my heart. But you can't see her anymore.
You're the best person I've ever met. Probably the best I will ever meet. But I'm not the same anymore.
We're now joined by the stars of Yung Libro sa Napanood Ko. We have Bella Padilla. Welcome back to the Philippines, Bella. And Korean actor Yoo Min Gon. Bella, good morning to you. And Min, good morning to you.
Good morning, Kevin. Thank you for having us.
Well, first of all, I want to start first with, let me start, Bella, with Min, okay?
Yeah,
just to like zoom him up a little this morning. Okay, so Min, welcome to the Philippines, Min. And I just want to ask you, how's your experience so far?
So far, so good. I'm adapting myself to this hot weather.
All right. Good answer. This is your first time in the country. I mean, you're only in the Philippines because of this movie.
Oh, yes.
And how did you meet Bella?
We have a mutual friend in Korea. She's also an actress, and I shot a movie with her like 5-6 years ago, and then 2 years ago when right before pandemic happened, Bella shot a movie with her called Ultimate Oppa. Yeah. And then Bella was looking for a Korean male lead who can speak English, so she asked our actress friend, like, do you have any? And she introduced me to Bella. So that's how we got together for this movie.
It's amazing. Bella, I mean, Bella's been on the show before, so this isn't the first time we're speaking to each other. I've always admired Bella because you're not only an actress, you're actually a brilliant writer too. And I've told you that before. So you just, not being in this film, but reprising it. This was an original Korean story, and then you wrote it into a Filipino film. That's correct?
No, sorry, no. Ahead, I didn't reprise it. I watched a Korean drama a few years ago in 2017, and it inspired me to write a different story, but with the same book in the center. So the title, yung libro sa napanood ko, is because in that K-drama, they spoke about a book, and it's To Room 19 by Doris Lessing. And that book inspired me so much. I got my own copy. It inspired me so much to create my own film. So
I apologize for that. The only thing, the inspiration is the book, the use of the book. Okay.
In a K-drama I watched.
Yeah, in a kid. Okay, so how did you have the courage for this, to get a Korean actor produce the film?
I know. I think this started because of the pandemic when we did 366, which I also wrote and directed. I feel like that gave me the first taste of really filmmaking behind the scenes. Yeah. And I shot that film partially in Turkey, and I had to fly alone, and I worked with a Turkish crew and production staff. Wow. And I think I at that time I felt like, you know, if you could do something like that during the pandemic, and if you could pull off a film during the pandemic, I think everything else will fall into place, you know, the same way. So I think that started it. And obviously I have a good team behind my back. So this film is also produced by Viva Films and my production house, Whiskey Marmalade. So Viva also guided me really well when we were doing this. So Tita June and Boss Vic, I consider them my mentors. And if they say this is a project I can do, I fully trust them because they've been doing this for decades.
Yes.
So yeah, I think I just had the right push from the right people. And I think that's something we have to highlight. And this is a conversation that keeps on coming up recently. Like I did a talk for Women's Month, and what I noticed everyone was saying on the panel is that they had one mentor believe in them. So I really feel like, you know, especially in this day and age, we're very individualistic, and we all know what our strengths are. But until we get the right push from the right people, it's still scary. So yeah, I'm just lucky I have that support system.
No, but I love the fact you put up your own production company, Whiskey Marmalade. I mean, it reminds me of Reese Witherspoon. Hello, Sunshine.
Hello, Sunshine.
Yes.
Cheatables.
And that's where you're going to go. Let's declare that. Yes. So, Min, I found the trailer quite interesting. The fact that when she used the word Jowa, and then you got it. Now, hindi ko siya Jowa. What's your role, Min, in the movie? I mean, tell me, are you a Korean and who's Filipino? How does that work?
My character is Korean, and he knows a little bit of English. I mean, the Tagalog.
Tagalog.
But if someone says Tagalog too fast, he can't really have hard time understanding. So just a bit of understandable Tagalog, and he is very nice, romantic guy who's deeply, deeply in love with Lisa, which was played by Bella. And yeah, I would say that like that.
Yeah. What made you say yes to this project?
Oh, I was always like eager for a lead role. And I remember when we had a Zoom course, me and Bella, and she actually asked me, there are two Korean characters. One is support and the other one is lead. And she described me both of them.
Okay.
And I told her that I can do that lead really well and are not disappoint you. And
this
then she gave me a role, and I was so surprised.
Yeah. No, but what I like about your story is, you know, is it fair to say that this is a big break for you because it's your first lead role?
Yes.
I'm so happy for you, Min.
Thank you.
This is great. And looking at it, Min, why do you think there's such a global acceptance of everything Korean? What happened? What shifted?
I think it's just Koreans' luck met their time.
Okay.
Because
Okay.
like about 15 to 20 years ago, when I was a little kid and I was in Canada,
Yeah.
nobody even know about Korea. Like whenever they asked me where I came from, I said Korea, and they would most of them ask me, "Where is Korea?" Or "Are you from North or South?" Like they
Yes,
don't even know
yes.
that North Koreans are not allowed to go out from outside the country. And
Yeah.
like, I rarely see Korean restaurants, but Koreans were doing their effort, putting their effort a lot to let the world know that there is a Korea. And now their luck and effort has met their time. That's what I think.
Yes, that's very good, and it's true, huh? Now, Bella, I mean, clearly you are one. You are a Korean novella addict yourself, right? So this is where it's coming from. But you are also riding the wave. Now, Koreans are known for, frankly, good storytelling, right?
Yes,
The
for
Korean
sure.
novellas—they're really known, just good storytelling, good production. Tell me, what were your inspirations? Did you want to do like a Korean-like movie too?
We didn't have any pegs for the film. I remember my cinematographer, Director Romel Salas, asking me like, "Do you want the shots to look like to look a bit like K-drama?" And I kept saying no. Like, let's not try to copy their style. Instead, let's make it our own. And it's just coincidental that we shot the film in Korea and that we have a Korean actor. I think one thing that works for Filipinos and the reason why K-dramas really appeal to us is a lot of their culture is also what we practice here. So they're very family oriented. The people our age are very hardworking. There's so many things we can relate to. We're both cultures are suckers for love stories. We do love a good love story. So a lot of what they put out appeals to us because it's what we aspire to be and aspire to have. So I didn't consciously make it an effort to make the film look like a K-drama. Instead, yun nga, parang I just made sure that it was clear that our setting was 30% in the Philippines and 70% in Korea. And
Okay, Bella, I don't mean to
yes.
interrupt. I'm curious. So
No, go
you
ahead.
are actor, are you your producer? Are you
Yes.
also the director?
Yes.
Wow. So you're lead actor, producer, and director. Hats off to you. So what was the most difficult part of the job? I'm sure the acting you have got down pat, or is it hard to do it all together?
Altogether, I think it's definitely a challenge, but I don't see it anymore as like what's the harder job? It's more like what do I do next and what's after this? So I try to I guess look at the bright side all the time in every project. And if I may, Karen, I just want to highlight like one of the main arcs of the story is also Miss Lorna Tolentino's character. So in the film, we also try to tackle the mental health state of OFW. So it definitely runs deeper than a typical love story. So I'm excited for people to watch it.
All right. Last words, parting words, Min. So what are you planning to do in the Philippines? What's up next?
As a product-wise,
No, I would have to say because you are plugging the film, right? You're promoting it. So where can people see you? Bella, Min, fans that wanna get your autograph.
We actually have a mall show this weekend.
Okay.
So got both of us in. I don't know yet what mall we're going to, but we'll post it on our social media accounts. So Mingon and I will both be there. And we have a premiere night tonight in SM Mega
Wow.
Mall, Cinema One at 6 p.m. If you guys want to join in, our film is finally showing and it will be out nationwide and in UAE territories starting April 8th.
Okay, no, congratulations to you. Mingon, anything you want to add?
And the people can follow me on Instagram, and
Yes.
I'm in Manila, so I'm most of times when I'm on break days, I just walk around myself or with Bella, because whenever she has time, she always like asks me to Mingon, do you wanna go there? Do you wanna come here? And she always tries to give me a best experience in Manila. So I might pop up in some random places in Manila.
All right. Well, Mingon, welcome to Manila. And I do hope you have good memories of the Philippines. And maybe, who knows, more projects also for you here in the Philippines soon. Thank you for being here, Mingon. And Bella, congratulations to you. I think you're doing a spectacular job following your dream. You just took that leap. So congratulations to you. Good luck to the movie.
Thank you.
You take care, both of you.